Welcome to my channel. I'm Zhang Jingxu. Let's look at the problem 6 at chapter 9. In this chapter, we will talk about the linear momentum. So first thing, the mass of this baseball is given. At the initial, it moves horizontally at 32 meters per second. What does that mean? That means initial velocity is 32 meters per second horizontally, right? So it moves this way. And then something happens, we don't care. And it strikes a bat. And then finally, it moves straight up, right? Moves straight up. So that means the velocity V2 straight up, but how much we don't know. And then it just moves up until the peak. The Y3 is 36.5 meter. And we find the time taking for velocity V1 changes V2 is given, delta t. Ask you to find the average force between this ball and the bat during the contact. So we need to find the force. So how can we do that? So first thing, we look at this part from V1 to V2. You can see we learned in this chapter, the change of the momentum divided by time taking is just the net force. Agree? So that means if we want to find the force, we need to know the change of the momentum divided by delta t. Now, the final momentum unknown, initial momentum easy. Next one, how can we find the final momentum? We need to find the V2 because the momentum is mass times V2, agree? Now, next question, how can you get V2? Look at this part. What's this part? The baseball just moves up. And we know the final velocity, final position. Can you find V2? And at the condition, you know Y2 is zero? Of course, this is just energy conservation we learned in the previous chapter, right? So in this part, the energy is conserved from V2 to V3. So we can see the energy at the position 2 is kinetic energy plus potential energy equals the energy at the position 3. Kinetic energy plus the position energy. And then we can input the known quantities. Y2 is 0, V3 is 0. So we can get the V2 very easily. After our calculation, we find the magnitude of V2, this one. Now, you know V2, you know V1. So you can find the final momentum, initial momentum. The change of the momentum divided by delta t is force. It looks we are done, right? So there we need to take care. This is we learned in this chapter. The change of the momentum divided by delta t is the net force. And we need to pay attention. The force V2 and V1 are vectors. So we need to write them in vector format. So in this one, the force can be written in this equation. So V2, because it tells us it moves straight up. So the drag component, agree? And the initial velocity V1 horizontally. So it is I component. Then we do this calculation, get the final answer. Because you know the force in the component format, so you can get the force very easily, the magnitude of the force, and it's even the angle. Thank you.